Years ago, a university professor in Seoul, Korea, invited Kate to come sing and speak to his students. They were studying American history, and particularly the American South. Kate performed a concert and offered commentary about her Southern-themed songs to a large auditorium filled with Korean students. The event concluded with a time for questions from the audience. Kate answered all the questions except for one. A Korean student went to the microphone and asked a question that was totally different from all the others. "I want to know about the song, Sweet Home Alabama," he said, "and the meaning of the lyrics. Well, I heard Mr. Young sing about her. Well, I heard O'Neill put her down. Well, I hope Neil Young will remember. A Southern man, don't need him around, anyhow. What do these lyrics mean?" Kate paused for a moment and then said, "I think I'll let my husband answer that question. I would like to say that I gave a brilliant answer, but I stammered through an explanation that probably left the young man even more confused than before about the lyrics. Now that I've had some time to think about it, maybe I have a better answer for the question." The late Ronnie Van Zant, the lead singer for Lynyrd Skynyrd, who wrote the lyrics to Sweet Home Alabama, did not dislike Neil Young. In fact, Ronnie Van Zant would sometimes wear a Neil Young t-shirt when Lynyrd Skynyrd performed concerts. He was certainly aware, as anyone who grew up in Alabama in the 50s and 60s was aware, that Alabama had its share of problems, especially when it came to racial issues. So when Neil Young, a Canadian, wrote a song called Southern Man that took Alabama and other Southern states to task for their troubled past, I think Ronnie Van Zant's lyrics were simply a way of saying, "Hey, we don't need a Canadian talking about our problems. We can do that ourselves." It's sort of like families who can talk about other members of their family in less than flattering ways, as much as they want or choose to do so. But they don't want anyone outside their family speaking negatively about their brother, sister, mother, or father. I think this kind of feeling is very common, and it is the very sentiment that Ronnie Van Zant expressed in his lyrics about Neil Young. But it is not just a Southern thing, it is universal across all cultures to not appreciate it when people outside of your community criticize or make judgments about the problems within your community. I grew up Southern Baptist, and I've done my share of criticizing the denomination of my childhood and youth. But I don't want to hear a Methodist or an Episcopalian making denigrating remarks about Southern Baptist. After all, they've got their own share of problems. In fact, all denominations, faith groups, families, communities, regions of the country, as well as all nations of the world, have plenty of their own shortcomings without having to criticize or make judgments about the problems of others. The words of Jesus come to mind. Why do you see the speck in your neighbor's eye, but do not notice the log in your own eye? I remember seeing a British animation movie about the life of Jesus. One of the scenes depicts a guy sawing a log in a carpenter shop when a speck of wood flies into his eye. He immediately begins to scream in pain and discomfort. About this time, another guy comes into the shop carrying a big load of logs, stacked so high they obstruct his view completely. The other guy yells, "Help me! Help me!" while his co-worker stumbles around, but he can't offer any assistance because there's a stack of logs in his own eyes. I had never interpreted or imagined the words of Jesus in this way, but it actually makes a lot of sense. Sometimes even secular rock songs can offer us some spiritual insights. Although in my home state, Sweet Home Alabama is more than just a rock song. It is a religious anthem, because for many people in Alabama, college football is a religion. And if that's true, Sweet Home Alabama is one of the most beloved hymns of faith, because it is played over the loudspeakers at every Alabama home football game. All thanks to Neil Young, who inspired Ronnie Van Zant to write the song. Thanks for listening, my friend. I'll simply close with a two-word phrase that people in Alabama use as a greeting both coming and going. Roll Tide.